We want to use the following probabilities to answer the question. It may be helpful to sketch a Venn diagram, which we will do. We're given the probability of A equals 0.56, the probability of B equals 0.34, and the probability of A and B equals 0.10. We want to find the probability of not B, given A has already occurred. This is conditional probability, which is defined below. Applying our definition, to find this conditional probability, we need to find the probability of A and not B divided by the probability of A. Now let's go ahead and complete our Venn diagram using the given probabilities. We'll start with the intersection of A and B. The probability of A and B equals 0.1, which would be the probability of being in this region here. Next, because the probability of A equals 0.56, it does include this probability because notice how this region is in A. So the probability of being in this region, which is only A, would be 0.56 minus 0.1, which is 0.46. And the probability of B equals 0.34, and again, this is included in the 0.34, so the probability of only B would be 0.34 minus 0.1, or 0.24. Now let's also find the probability of being in this outer region, which would be the probability of being in the universal set, but not in A and not in B. This would be equal to 1 minus the sum of these three probabilities, which would be 0.2. Again, this is the probability of being not in A and not in B. Of course, we can check this on the calculator. 1 minus the quantity 0.46 plus 0.1 plus 0.24 does give us 0.2. And now before we find these two probabilities, let's highlight the region A and not B, as well as A. Let's start with the easy one. The region A is this region here. Because of the conditional probability that says not B given A, we can already assume we're in this region here. And the tricky part here is what region is A and not B? So it has to be in A and not in B, which would be the region that's only A, or this region here. So notice how to find this conditional probability. We take the probability of A and not B, which is the probability of only A, which is 0.46. And we divide by the probability of A, which we know is given as 0.56, which is also the sum of these two probabilities. So again, what happened here is to find this conditional probability, we took the probability of the desired region, highlighted here in orange, and divided by the probability of the total region, given that we already knew we were in A, which was the probability of A. Let's first clear the decimals from our fraction, so we can multiply by 100 over 100, which would give us 46.56. But now we have a common factor of 2, so we can divide the numerator and denominator by 2. So the simplified probability as a fraction would be 23/28. Let's also write this as a decimal and percentage. To convert to a decimal, we divide. So 23 divided by 28 to 4 decimal places would be approximately 0.8214. To convert to a percentage, we multiply by 100, add a percent sign, or move the decimal point to the right 2 places and add a percent sign, giving us 82.14%. Notice how the exact probability would be the fraction. Because these two are rounded, these would be approximations. So for homework, we should enter the exact probability as 23/28, but also recognize that often probability is written as a decimal or percentage. I hope you found this helpful.